So there's a rousing start. Before we bring him back and start all the cool rock stuff, bluegrass stuff, we're going to feature the students. And we've prepared a movement of St. Paul's Suite. This is a great piece, one of the great string orchestra pieces. This is the first movement called Jig, and it's by Gustav Holst.
Stephanie Strait on the set. Join us.
Tricks and stuff over the years, and it's kind of known as the national anthem of fiddling. I think you have new programs, the Orange Blossom Special.
Yes. Thank you.
You'll hear elements that kind of sound like the blues, and it's not by accident. Things kind of developed in tandem and parallel. And the fiddle, I've heard, is said to be the first blues instrument until Sears and Roebuck started making the guitar available, widely available, and people started buying that when it was cheap enough, and it was easier to play along to while you, or to play along with yourself while you sang. And anyway, so then you got fiddlers going, like the Orange Blossom Special, but with the electric guitar, you had similar kinds of things going on with, Chuck Berry kind of pioneered a bit of the electric guitar for us, and so I like to play this after the Orange Blossom Special, because it kind of reminds me of it a little bit. This is Johnny B. Goode.
Thank you.
came along before Chuck Berry. And he had that. Into some of Chuck Berry's solos too. So anyway, then fast forward a little bit further, and you had a kid who was in high school in California playing the cello and also picked up the electric guitar, and he became a big guitar player in the United States, and his name was Eddie Van Halen. And when I was these kids' age, I was listening to Van Halen with my friends, and we were all listening to this one tune played by him on an album that wasn't even meant to be on an album. He was just in the recording studio messing around during a break in a session. And he was playing around with this kind of fast riff guitar solo type thing. And the engineer said, hey, that sounds really great. We should record that. So they did. And it became one of the most famous guitar solos of all time. So I learned it when I started out playing electric violin for young person's concerts. National Symphony does at the Kennedy Center. We bus in kids to the theater from school districts, and they wanted me to play electric violin. So I learned Eruption off of Guitar Hero on YouTube. and because at that time all the kids were playing Guitar Hero, so they all knew the piece and were just figuring along. So that's what kind of got me to the electric slugger, and without having played the Eruption on that concert, I might never have gotten to be here before you today doing this. So here's Eruption by Eddie Van Halen. Oh, one other interesting thing is, since he was in high school orchestra, like everyone here, in addition to having his band that he was forming with his brother and others, he got exposed to a lot of classical music and etudes and such that you play on the violin. And so you're going to hear a famous Kreutzer etude that Jack Benny used to play on his show very badly as kind of a musical joke. And Eddie put it right into his Eruption. So you'll hear a little bit of singing. I'll look up at you so you know when it's there. Here's Eruption.
Thank you. mic because he was actually my string quartet coach when I was in high school. He did music. He was a music major at Western, right? And was going into teaching. And he did student teaching with my mom, who was then the orchestra director at Ferndale High School. And so he'd come up to the house after school or whatnot, and he'd coach me and my brother and two of our friends. And we just had a blast with him. We thought he was the coolest guy in the world. And now he's gone on to do all kinds of great things with education and has made his way back around to Bellingham. To be the assistant superintendent or whatever the position is, Mr. Number Two, and he's the one who's instrumental in bringing me to the Bellingham schools this week, which I've just thoroughly enjoyed doing, and we'll hit a couple more next week, and also this concert tonight. So I really want to thank him for all that he does for your kids and their music education here in the Bellingham schools. So this next one is basically, now we're going into heathen territory and just rock and roll. When I was young, I went berry picking, Boxes Berry Farm and such, and I remember riding the berry bus, and it was more lenient in the summer. People brought their boom boxes, and during lunch and on a bus ride, they'd listen to AC/DC, Back in Black, all the time, Highway 2, something or other. And that was like our anthem of the summer, those songs. And so it's just kind of fun to nod back to that and play it with some other kids who seem to like it too.